بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم. So now we're moving on to the next chapter. So if you look at it here, I said to you, I made my own arbitrary headings. So we had the مقدمة, where we discussed some basic fundamentals. Yes. After that, we discussed the باب الأول, which was what ماضي مضارع أمر نهي نون تأكيد اسم الفاعل مفعول. Now we're going to apply all of these rules of ماضي مضارع أمر نهي نون تأكيد اسم الفاعل مفعول to مضاف. You know what مضاف is? We still go through attention. You understand? This is what we do. We are مضاف. So what is مضاف? The types of مضاف and the rules that apply to مضاف. Okay. Now continue from here. So الباب الثاني في المضاف. So مضاف literally means to double or to increase. What does it mean? Double or increase. What comes in the Quran? يضاعف لهم العذاب. Allah will double the punishment. Or come out of the place. ضعف 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 ضاعف مضاعف. All this means what? To multiply, to increase. So مضاعف is meaning ويقال له الأصم لشدته. مضاعف is also called what? أصم. So the keyword. Another name for مضاعف is what? أصم. So أصم has two meanings. The meaning here we're looking for, one is also means to be deaf. But here also means here أصم is called, it means here صلب أو شديد. Something is called hard. Something is very hard, you call it what? أصم. Something is very severe, you call it شديد, you call it what? أصم. So for example, Arabs, they use the, you see the word, Arabs use the word, they say what? حجر أصم. حجر أصم, meaning a very hard rock. So it's harder. What's hard? What's easier? فعلة أو مرة؟ What's harder or easier? What's easier? And what's شديد? مرة شدة فرة. You got to get a clock and time it. فرة. I see how it's pronounced quicker. Yeah. But obviously it's more severe in it. It's got a شدة on it. So you call مضاعف also. It's also called what? Al asam. Because why? It's harsh. But that's not that commonly. The main common rule is what? It's called what? مضاعف. So now you have مضاعف, مضاعف ثلاثي, and مضاعف رباعي. So what's مضاعف ثلاثي, what's مضاعف رباعي? We're discussing that here. So مضاعف ثلاثي, وهو, meaning المضاعف, وهو, أي? The مضاعف from ثلاثي مجرد أن مزيد في is as follows, مبتدأ. وهو, yes? So from the ثلاثي مجيد, the ثلاثي مزيد, ثلاثي مجرد, and the ثلاثي مزيد في مضاعف. So we can say here, the ثلاث, the مضاعف of, which means it as what? Of. The مضاعف of ثلاثي مجرد, and the مضاعف of ثلاثي مزيد في, is what? Is this. Is that whose عين كلمة and لام الكلمة. Is that? ما كان عينه ولام. Is that whose عين كلمة and whose لام كلمة من جنس واحد. Is from what? One type. Correct? So if you have the عين كلمة and the لام كلمة, what are they? They're both the same. This is called what? مضاعف. كرد وأعد. Like رد and أعد. So رد is from باب نصر ينصر, and عد is باب إفعال. So one is مجرد and one is مزيد في. فإن أصلهما, because the origin. So the origins of رد and أعد is ردد وأعدد. What is it? فعل. أفعل أكرم أعدد. So he's not explaining. We do it in coming up shortly. فأسكنت الدال الأولى. أسكن يسكن إسكان. What do you think it means? To give سكون. To أسكنت الدال الأولى. So you have دال الأولى, دال الثانية. This is the دال number one, دال number two. So الدال الأولى becomes what? ساكن. وأدغمت في الثانية. Even here, you do that. You make this a ساكن. رد. But then you give the fatha from here over here. There's another rule later on. So أعد. Yes? So رد. So you get, when you have two letters which are similar, you make the first one ساكن and merge it together. We call it amalgamation. Amalgamate. Whatever, one of those words, yeah? I'll look it up later on, yeah? Okay. And مضاعف, that's مضاعف what? ثلاثي and مضاعف? No? مزيد في. So مضاعف, مجرد and مضاعف. مزيد فيه. What about مضاعف رباعي؟ ومن الرباعي أي The مضاعف from the رباعي is ما كان, because obviously رباعي is going to be what? فا عين لام أن لام. Correct? So the رباعي, the رباعي مضاعف is that who is فا, is that who is فا, and لامه الأولى is first لام من جنس واحد, is from one type, one species, meaning same. وكذلك similarly عينه, similarly عينه ولامه الثانية من جنس واحد, and the second lam is from the same type. For example, do we already? Look at my heart. زلزلة. Okay. For example, نحو زلزلة يزلزل زلزلة وزلزالا. So what's happened here? You have فا كلمة اللام الأولى, and then you have عين كلمة اللام الثانية. So look, this and this are the same, and this are the same. Yes. ويقال له المطابق أيضا. It's also called المطابق. What does طباق mean? طبقا. Layer upon layer. You layer it. Yes. So isn't it layered? If you're a kid, oh, that's got a pattern, abba. Pattern in it. زل زل زل. One layer. Next layer is زل زل. So layer one is زل. Layer two is. So it's as if you layered the زل زل. So زل زل. So زل زل. So you have layers upon layers of زل. Yes. Correct. So if you have a مضاعف, it's also مضاعف from رباع is also called what? مطابق. That which has been layered one upon the other. Yes. So مضاعف is called is what? Is also called أصم, and the مضاعف رباعي specifically is called what? مطابق. Yes. Understood. Now the question is, well, this is not really hard. This is not like all of these, like we mentioning these and the non صحيح. Don't we say, well, أقسام السبعة, what's أقسام السبعة from النون الأفعال صحيح. Then you have مضاعف. The معتل. Why are you making مضاعف like معتل? Why are you shoving مضاعف down معتل? It's not hard for إلا in there, is it? You follow? Is it hard for إلا in here? So why do we like push it down? Why do we like say you're not صحيح? We don't want you here. Because it says وإنما. So that's the question, isn't it? So why are you making مضاعف along with it? So وإنما ألحق المضاعف بالمعتلات. مضاعف is attached. مضاعف is only attached or joined or connected to معتل. The مضاعف is only attached, joined to the معتل. So I explain shortly. So look, what happens? Look at this word here. What's this word? What's that supposed to be? What say guys? قال يقول وصيغة زي المجهول of the ماضي مضارع. ماضي مضارع. ماضي. Right. Had a brain freeze. Okay. So قويلة becomes what? What do we do? We do إبدال, don't we? We change the word, don't we? So you change it to what? قيلة. You think what's قويلة. So you don't have قويلة, but it's already قويلة نصيرة. Then you change it. When you have the word أمللت, what's that? صحيح مضاعف. مضاعف. So you can change أمللت, you can also do إبدال in this. And أمللت becomes what? أمليت. So the Arabs do what? So مضاعف, what do they do? Sometimes? Do إبدال. So isn't that the same? Same rule applies? You have the word قولنت. You do قلب. You do حزف, you change the واو, you change the واو into قولنت. There's also other rules to do later on. But قولنت becomes what? So مسست becomes what? حزف. Miss to. So similar rules that apply to not miss you, miss to. Yeah? Correct? What happens now? When you have the rules of mu'tal sometimes also apply to mudaf. So they're similar. So now we bring mudaf and we add the mudaf onto what? Onto our mu'tal rulings. Pardon me? There are rules, can't do anywhere. Then you write something, I don't understand. Oh, I don't know the rule. You don't know the rule, Marana. I made my own rule up. Can't do that. وإنما ألحق المضاعف بالمعتلات لأن حرف التضعيف يلحقه الإبدال والحذف. And مضاعف is attached in our discussion to معتلات. معتلات means those that are حرف الحذف إلا, meaning أجوف, مثال, الناقص, and the murakkab. So mudha'af is only attached to mu'talla because the harf al-tad'if, meaning the doubled letter. So radda, the second, the double letter. The harf al-tad'if, yalhaquhu affects. We say affects. Or comes onto it. I don't know if it's effect or effects. I'm not teaching English, so I'm not sure. It could be effects or effects. I have to check it up. I know the difference, but I can't remember which one is which. There's a code I remember I made up before I forgot the code as well. Yeah? You got it? One is a verb, one is a noun. You remember which one is a verb, which one is a noun? I think effect is a verb. Because I remember it's so hard. So when a verb should be a V-E-R, so effect, but then it doesn't make sense in English, so it's effect. It doesn't matter my code anyways. Yeah? I'm teaching Arabic, not English. Okay? So what happens? That mudha'af is also affected by the same changes that affects what? The mu'tallat. So mudha'af is attached in our discussion to mu'tal because the harf al-tad'if is affected by ibdal and hadaf. Or ibdal and hadaf come onto this. So ibdal means to change. So amlaytu ka qawlihim amlaytu bima'na amlaltu. When they say amlaltu, yes? So they say amlaytu instead of amlaltu. Instead of amlaltu, what do you say? So what have they done? They've done ibdal. They change one letter to the other. That also happens in what? In the what? Mu'tallat. Then we have hadaf. We remove a letter. كَقَوْلِهِمْ مَسْتُ وَظَلْتُ بِفَتْحِ الْفَا وَكَسْرِهَا ظَلْتُ or ذِلْتُ. Yes? Yes? So you can say مَسْتُ أَمِسْتُ or ظَلْتُ and ذِلْتُ. Both of them you can say مَسْتُ أَمِسْتُ and ذَلْتُ or ذِلْتُ. Both of them. Fihima wa ahastu ay masistu an ahastu. You can say so mistu dhaltu originally wa masistu and dhaliltu. What do you do? You drop it. Say mastu and dhaltu or mistu and dhiltu. And ahsastu and ahastu becomes was really ahsastu.
What is mastu?
To touch. Dhaltu is from dhalla to remain. And ahastu is to sense. Okay? So because
So masaka, same meaning as
mis. No, that's different. Miskun is a perfume. It's a masun, to touch. What were you asking?
Amsik.
That's a kafa then. Amsik, that's a kafa then. Okay?
Can you say both amlaytu and amlaltu?
Yeah, you can say both are used. Amlaytu and amlaltu. You can say mas. What comes to the Quran? Dhalta alayhi akifa. So, it's supposed to be what? Dhalilta alayhi akifa. Yeah? Amlaytu wal amlaytu lil-kafirin. Yeah? You following? So now we know what mudha'af is. Mudha'af thulathi and mudha'af ruba'i. Mudha'af thulathi, mujarrad mazif is called asam. Mudha'af ruba'i is called mutabaq. Why is it? What's it called? It's also called asam. Asam because it's very harsh, has a shadda in it. And mudha'af ruba'i does not have a shadda, so it's called mutabaq. And what's a mudha'af? Where the ayn kalima and the lam kalima have the same letter. And in the mudha'af, in the ruba'i, with the ayn and the first lam and the fa and the first lam and the ayn and the second lam have the third letter. But mudha'af ruba'i, there's no changes to it. There's no, because it's separate. There's no idgham in that. Because separate it's zalzala. The za and the lam are separated. The second za and the lam. So there's no issue in that. The main issue comes about in what? In this next one. Subhanallah wa bihamdi, subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika wa nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta wa nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayka.